G'day, g'day, g'day. Welcome to Deb, and we have Simmers and Simmers Gigolo, and up against Sunbeam, and also Sunbeam's Pimp, which I am Sunbeam's Pimp today, watching him play in this tournament, this practice game. Panzer Grenadier by 4, and that's obviously Greek 393, if you didn't realize. That's a guy that makes a sexual joke out of everything, and doesn't matter what kind of sexual joke it is, it should be directed to the same sex or whatever. Usually it's not the case, and he has many giggles on that. So let's see how this goes. Grenadiers, not too good. I don't think these elite marksmen are that great. Their rifles aren't as good as the USA ones, and especially if it's not the beta patch, not the new patch where the stamina's improved. He gets there sooner. Let's see what Simmers has. Assault squad. Okay, the usual, and a few singles on the left. Didn't go on the west at all. Interesting. Greek wants to give him a Sherman. He's just joking. Western point. No one there. I think it's quite an easy point to send, maybe one or two guys to throw a grenade. Should have actually gone for that, in my opinion. But manages to get this point for some reason. Simmers' guys hasn't got to the sandbag. But they may take out quite a few. No, got one guy in the sandbag and the other guy as well. 3 versus 1, he should get the Eastern, and center still no one's. Panzer Grenadiers, I don't think, are doing too well in the shootout. I don't think they'll be able to do too much. Probably better used in closer range where they can one-shot things and also throw grenades. Use them to the best of their ability. Oh, cool grenade. Panzer Grenadier chose the wrong timing to run in and gets hit by the explosion. More troops coming though. We have rifles. Lots of singles by Sunbeam. Just keeping up the infantry flow, I suppose. Not getting anything big. The downside of doing this is, of course, not getting the assault squad leader. And also interruption and lots of micro. But infantry flow is where this benefits. And we see Mr. Simmers already sneaking a guy onto the western area. Good play. You don't usually see people doing that so early in the game, but it's actually the best to do it early in the game because you can most likely get through at the early part of the game. Definitely should be something you should be twitch at. So just should be a reflex thing really to just send a guy, at least one guy, to the side. Even though you do need, survive that grenade. I guess that's one of the good things about the Elite Marksman. You can survive a lot of hits. I was going to say, even though you do need all your troops to be involved in the firefight and shootout at the start, because one infantryman can make the difference, but you can also say one infantryman won't make a difference, and that's why he's sent to the cross. And it is possibly looking in the spawn right now, somewhere in the back. So center is being held well. Panzer unit is one-shotting a lot of units coming close. This is where they do good, these elite marksmen, I find. They are able to just one-shot things with good accuracy, and really take hits in the grenade throwing, and also take hits, when you're throwing a grenade as well. But here is a push here on the the eastern point with another assault squad, I'm assuming, and also another conscript squad in the center. This is good. One thing that's good versus elite marksman is a mixture of assault squads and conscripts, I believe, because this is horrible. This runs in here and gets slaughtered. By the way, let's see how the ping is. Wait, how is the lag? Better than last game? Let's have a look what this says, because Bessie Sunbeam hosted last time, and they get around 40 MS to each other. Really good MS. I guess they're too busy to type. But I'm hosting this time, because I'm hosting direct IP. None of these guys has the right ports forwarded. And I'm curious, they're on 260 to 220 MS. Well, both pretty even. Sunbeam spiking to 300 even. Wonder if the MS is actually... the game's smoother in direct IP at higher MS. Like butter, smooth as butter. Netcode, Steam, and DMS. So basically, I got that from the horse's mouth. Simmers thinks it's much smoother than the 50 MS game they had before. Like butter, smooth as butter, Simmers says. Direct IP is the way to go, guys. If you in the tournament, definitely try to work out how to forward your ports and then play direct IP, because there's literally no lag. And this is not even at a low MS game. No glitching, no throwing grenades, no not being able to move your units, no units stuck in spawn. All those queuing problems are all Steam related netcode issues, and if you are unhappy about that, definitely please let DMS know about this. Bloody remind them, just remind them that this is a big problem, and playing on direct IP is so much smoother and playable, and it doesn't frustrate people. And why can't it run like this? Just create a new lobby, just don't use the Steam lobby, get them to bloody make a different just don't go through Steam is the problem. The 222 is out, quite an early one, supporting the troops, decent buy. It's quite exposed, I suppose, and in the open, maybe should go down a bit lower, because if he goes lower, the unit that's coming to counter will have to come closer, and he'll be able to see it. But a nice flank, really good flank. 222, destroyed. And going to the center point, should be able to push. Nice. So really effective, this is the effective use of the 222 this time. Very good. And pulling her away to most likely go on the western point, which should be its goal. And he's got a lot of infantry in the center, he could potentially just sweep them over to the right, western point. Oh, 222 is actually playing really safe, so he's waiting for the counter. I can't hear one. Maybe it's an AT gun that's coming. I don't see the bushes rustling. Here's the guy Simmers was hiding, and oh no, he's gonna throw it because he knows it's already been discovered. Oh, takes out two Brandenburgers, nice. Something doesn't know. He still doesn't know. Oh, that's funny. So he's going to the right now, and this guy is still hidden. Not anymore. There he goes. Center though is being pressured by Simmers quite well. 7-8, this is quite an even game. A lot of troops in the center though, from Sunbeam at the top. Should be able to outshoot. 2-2 in a nice position, being able to fire at both flags in a way. And question mark, why is it? Oh, it's question mark because we're paying direct IP, that's what it is. So the left side is being taken by Simmers. And the western point still not being capped. So 2-2 domination, quite good. M3, let's see if it hits. Nice. I thought that sandbag might have blocked it, but nice shot here by Simmers. Takes out the 2-2-2. And eastern point going to Simmers. And western point also going to Simmers. Another 2-2-2 out. I suppose it's okay, because it's got an M3. M3 can't really chase it. If it knows where the if the 222 does know, or Sunbeam does know the M3's location, it can just totally avoid that area. Staying quite far away as well. Should be okay. And Sunbeam is kind of infesting his Brandenburgers in the backfield. And nice, SDG-44 takes out two. And here comes a flank. Oh, 2-2-2. Bam. Ooh. Whoa, bam. Bad luck there for that US Marine. This is why you should always send a few guys on the sides even. So Sunbeam should just buy a few single infantry and just put one in spaced out position just to make sure that none of these incidents happen. Lucky it was only a 2-2-2, and lucky he dodged it as well. So, interesting play. Sunbeam giving up one side, and Simmers is really trying to flank him from this eastern point. And also a big push coming up. Waiting for the croc, perhaps, and this is the grenade. Two grenades at one time, meaning he's using the new grenade method. Good play. Croc is out, though. Croc is out. 3 points. I hear it. No, I don't. You must have forgot. 2-2 still dominating. And a nice push from Simmers, coming down probably from his eastern point, pushing down the riverway to flank, and grabs the center. 2-2, not being able to do too much versus the guys behind the pipes. And also on the western, Sunbeam has got it as well somehow, a sneaky guy somewhere on this area. And a turnaround, 12-10, very even game, paratroopers are coming to the center. Interesting. Moved up the infantry tier. Decent play, I suppose. There's nothing, no infantry killers out. And that's one thing you shouldn't do, really, when buying elite troops is when there is infantry killer out. Here comes a croc. He's kind of infantry killer. And if there's no Brandenburgers around, it's definitely going to have a nice barbecue. Oh, what a shaky shell. Bam, hits the rock. Didn't mean that, I'm guessing. It's doing decent HE shell damage. No Brandenburgers in sight. Perhaps over here though. I see him. Why are you running? Oh no, are you crazy? What are you doing? He's noticed. Oh, finally. But miraculously, none of Sunbeam's troops notices it. Ooh. Wait for it. Wham! Sunbeam has taken him out on the side. Oh, even this M3, this one Brandenburger has got the Iron Cross for sure. Another shot, another grenade, just one more. Oh, what are you doing? One more grenade would have taken it out. But a good lead from Simmers, even though he lost the big ticket items. Look, 69-129, 2-1, flag points, 20-12, ticking up fast. Somebody needs to really get into damage control now and take one of the flags ASAP, any flag, just to stop the points going fast. Another Brandenburger squad out, so spent about 5, I'm guessing. Sniper Brandenburger, then a Brandenburger again. M3 in a different position. He's been spotted though. And here comes an assault. Don't think there'll be anything to stop it. Brandenburger squad with a 2-2 in tow. Simmers a nice spread though. Not making it easy for Sunbeam to push in. And center point is still Sunbeam's. Or is Sunbeam's now. And the flag points will go back to Sunbeam. 28-12, the good lead. I think it was definitely worth it, I guess, the 3 points. Not really worth it, because that croc had nothing to do with, losing that croc had nothing to do with getting the three points. It was in fact just a sneaky ambush on the side. So M3 at least is on the field, stopping the 2-2 from supporting the west point and center. Just probably needs to storm his infantry down, and he'll be safe with that M3 gun there. 2-2 can't really approach. M3 is being a bit scared, moving back. Yeah, assault squad coming to the center. So still a majority, not anymore. Center's gone to Sunbeam. And Simmers in not a good position with the fire shootout, with a 2-2 and a lot of infantry coming. Bam. So M3 gun, crew injured, engine damaged, one more shot, boom, oh, bounced, lucky, another shot, boom, that's gone. Flaming wreck, 15-31, this is a close game, very close game. Sunbeam has, I'm guessing, 5 special points. Simmers, I'm guessing, has 3 special points. Or maybe even 5, I don't know, I didn't see the 2nd Marine squad. 50 cal. Coming up to assault the Eastern most likely, but on the way support a center assault. Being a bit slow right now though. Needs to run and get down into the flag quickly. It's out in the open for too long this half track, and 222 will be able to take it out. Bit hard now. Oh, needs to go lower though. Oh, half track's being too... See, it's right in the open, easy pickings. Down at the bottom wouldn't have been easy pickings. M380 gun, where is it? Should definitely have been ready for that. Half track was out, there's something coming for that, for sure. Should have expected this to just run down over here. M3 should have just been waiting with bated breath. Simmers should have been looking at the AT gun and just getting ready to click the button. But instead, he was probably scratching his balls. Don't know why. 31-22. M3. Look at this. Boom. Another one. Boom. Nah. Big mistake. Half track could have sealed the deal, captured the center at least, at the minimum. And then 2-2 down would have taken the eastern point. Simmers would have just said bam, and then bam onto the eastern. Just half track moving from both flags. 2-2 down. Just didn't play out that way because Simmers wasn't controlling the right unit at the right time. And he didn't move the half track down to the riverway. Down the riverway, the half track is a 50-50 against the 2-2 as well. 2-2 needs to come up around there to take a shot. Half track can take it out. Unfortunate there. Just, I guess sometimes it's definitely hard to do. Then he probably knew what to do, but just was too pressured in the moment. Not second croc out, I'm guessing. Yep, second croc out. Definitely the standard for most USA players. Two crocs. On a map like Deb, perhaps not all the time. Oof. Conscripts just stopped the Brandenburger. Definitely nice play by Simmers, moving down units with the croc. But whoa. This SMG, bam. MP40, the whole conscript squad dead. Croc is on the field though, with no counter from Sunbeam. 31 all. What can he do? Needs more infantry. What's going on with that croc? Do something. 2-2-2. Okay, what do we have here? Guess he has the element of surprise. Kind of a 50-50. But he's sending some singles, I guess. He's quite cautious of being flanked by something hidden. Fair call. Good play, especially because he hasn't got any line of sight in the western point for a very long time. Simmers does cap it back. 34-31. So close this game is. So, crew injured, croc, remember at this range, the G may find it harder to attack because it has to hit the bottom weak area or the top where the croc can hit anywhere and kill it at this range. Sunbeam should be staying as far as possible from this croc. Sorry, Sunbeam. Oh, 2-2-2! Dead, but whoa, that's a free 2-2-2. Geez, see, this is the problem with the G. You need to stay far and hit the right locations. See, it's not easy to do on some areas. So let's see. I'm guessing the croc will win unless the G gets lucky. See, keeps hitting the wrong place, hitting there, see that there, has to hit right there or right there, especially on an angled Sherman. Watch the tutorial I've sent, by the way. Oh, I've uploaded. Two, two, two. Simmers is moving towards victory shortly. And I don't know if he can counter the croc after that big loss of that G. Double G, if he bought a G, that means he couldn't afford a H. And that means he has no MP left after that G. So that means, he has to really avoid that croc to win. He's probably going to have to force infantry play, so maybe just send a lot of infantry down to the western point and try win that way. And also, actually Sunbeam has this 2-2-2 if he wants. It's just decrewed, it's not destroyed. It said main gun damage, but you can't main gun a 2-2-2, it's a bug. So it says main gun damage, but it's actually fully functional. 2-2-2. Let's go. Fast swing. Go all the way back so the croc can't take you around this area. The croc can't fight you. And you got Brandenburgers too. This is a perfect ambush unit. So this could turn around. This is a chance for Sunbeam. 6 points though. 5 points to go. It needs to make a move now. See, croc can't take it. It needs to make a move quickly. It's struggling though to aim at the guy behind the rock. 4 points to go, he needs to keep a look on the clock. Brandenburgers should have been waiting around here too. This croc might even come down to this area to take a side shot at 2-2 quickly. He didn't move quick enough, I don't know why he sent a unit up here for nothing. He needs this. Just run in there. Quick. Your Brandenburgers have weighted the cap too, just get in there. Yes. Oh, this happened way too late. Come on. Ooh, he's got it. Now Brandenburgers can potentially ambush this guy. Look, this guy here from Sunbeam. This is what I was saying all along. Just needs to avoid this puppy. Go along the route here. And just send a few more guys into the flag point quickly. Oh no! We missed the Brandenburger. There's another one. But at least it's made Simmers run away. He's cautious. He knows Brandenburger's around. He's just going to pull back a bit or go from another area. 2-2-2 could potentially come over this area there. Just play cat and mouse and then attack the center. Oh no, didn't preempt that. It was a bit slow to do. And doesn't look like he's going to stop it. There's no Brandenburgers around. Panzerfaust? No, it's flamed and it's going to be taken. This guy must be hot. Still alive, but he's definitely hot. Start getting a nice eyebrow removal. Looks. Crack. Oh, takes that rifleman. And his looks running away. So yeah, guys, remember, this is a get direct IP working for you guys in the tournament. Anyone who plays with friends to get it working, because you realize how bad the netcode is in Steam and DMS coding. They say it's Steam, and it is Steam, but why can't they fix it? Or why can't they create a new lobby connection system instead of going through Steam, which is slowing everything down? It's so smooth with direct IP. So smooth. Bam. GG's, I'm guessing. Nice play by Sunbeam, able to get the center though, even though he didn't have them. In fact, if you just spam more infantry, perhaps you can win. Oh no, Croc's doing a decent amount of damage and there's a lot of troops coming in. I think there's too many now. And there's nothing else coming from Sunbeam in this spawn. And I'm going to call it. Calling. Oh, I shouldn't say that. That's a bit rude. G is coming out, and this is going to be too late. Way too late. Once he caps his flag, there's no turning back. Half track going to seal the deal on the eastern point, potentially. G is going to have to fire at one of them. Fired at the half track, but now it's in danger from the croc. Ooh. Better off going a bit closer. Oh, both miss. See, hitting the wrong places. It angled so well, Simmers. Really not easy to penetrate that angle. Wow, I'm surprised that the H is actually, the G is actually holding. Anyway, good game.